Good evening and welcome. It's lovely to welcome you to Holy Trinity Church Leakey. If we've not met before, my name's Sherry, I'm vicar in the parish here in Leakey and Blackwell, and therefore I'm also Roger and Mary's vicar. That's a homage. If you've not been inside church here before, then a reminder that our facilities, the accessible ones, are right at the back of church, just by the tea and coffee area, and some more down the steps behind us as well. I've been asked to encourage you to be ready to stay at the end, because there is plenty of tea and cake to enjoy before you leave. I think the rules are 4 slices of cake before you can leave the building. We've not had to buy tickets this evening, have we, to enjoy this treat? Instead of tickets, we are asked to donate towards the ministry of CMM. And you can do that by either popping a cash donation into the basket that's just at the back of church there as you leave, or just, it's much easier for them, pop onto the CMM website where you can make an online donation there. That's much easier for you, isn't it? Much easier. So online donation on the CMM website or cash in the basket at the back of the church. Well, I think that's it for me. Anyway, I'm going to sit down and hand over to Annie. Thank you, Annie. Oh, I'd love to pray for you to start. God of love, we want to thank you for the ministry of CMM. Thank you for the blessing that CMM have been over these past 25 years. Thank you for the way that you've warmed hearts, that you've deepened understanding, that you've transformed people through the ministry of the Lord. And Lord, this evening, as the choir sings, as we listen, would you speak to each one of our hearts afresh this evening? Come by your Spirit, we pray. In Jesus' name, we ask these things. Amen. Thank you, Sherry. And thank you all for coming to treat and chat over a full audience. My name is Annie Radley, and I've got the privilege of conducting this wonderful group of singers. And we're from different churches all over the West Midlands, and we exist to build up and encourage each other in our faith in Jesus and to sing the musicals of Roger Jones, who's with us this evening. He's going to share a word with us later. You don't have to audition to be in the CMM choir. We'd be very happy if you wanted to come and join us. This evening's programme, as we've said, is a celebration of our 25 years together as a choir. So, we're going to open in the same way that King Charles started his coronation service, with a setting of, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go up to the house of the Lord.
I was glad when you said to me, there's a joke in the house of the Lord. musicals became popular far wider than Birmingham. And in 1984, Roger left the security of a good teaching job and went into full-time Christian music ministry. His desire was to see the churches of East Birmingham and further afield renewed by the Holy Spirit.
Each of Roger's new musicals was launched in Birmingham, with local Christians joining the choir to sing in the world premiere before it went on tour around the UK and beyond. But in the early 1990s, Roger wrote the musical Jairus' Daughter for the Girls' Brigade, and this was sung by massed choirs of girls up and down the country. Phil Parkin was working in the CMM office at the time, and so he decided to start CMM Choir for the many singers who enjoyed Roger's musicals but wouldn't have an opportunity to sing in Jairus.
Phil's choice of song for this evening is the opening number from Jairus' Daughter, the motto of the Girls' Brigade, to seek, serve and follow Christ.
Serve CMM and continue doing his musicals.
So Sylvia formed CMM Choir West Birmingham, meeting on Mondays in Harlem. Sylvia has chosen the song Praise to the Holiest from the musical Snakes and Ladders. In her own words, this is because praise is one way of expressing our thanks to God for the sacrifice Jesus made for us on the cross and for his love and blessings given to us daily.
In 2005, Phil Parker Martin retired from the CMM office and CMM choir. Music teacher Penny Weevil took up the baton, and over the next 5 years, CMM choir performed many of Roger's musicals.
Penny's choice of song is engraved upon my palms from the musical Snakes and Ladders. Penny says that this is a song that really resonates with her about how God's love for us as a father and mother never changes. When we're going through difficult times, and as a family they have been through a lot, the knowledge of God's eternal love helps them and us through the difficulties.
Upon my throne,
Birmingham CMM Choir, meeting on Tuesdays at Christ Church in Ward End until the COVID pandemic. Stella had attended church as a child, but had drifted away in her teens. Through the trauma of bereavement and a near-death experience, Stella found fellowship at her local church in Marston Green and was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Stella found Roger's musicals very helpful, particularly Rock, the story of Simon Peter, as she could identify with Peter's ups and downs. Stella has found being part of Christian Music Ministries a great help in her spiritual journey. Sadly, she is no longer able to come and sing with the choir, but she has chosen the song "This Is the Place" from Rock, as it emphasises that we are led to meet Jesus in the right place at the right time, as she herself has experienced.
Thank you.
been working alongside Roger Jones with Christian Music Ministries for nearly 30 years. She is a music graduate, playing viola and piano, and she typesets all the music books and writes the orchestral parts and other arrangements for CMM.
Annie had often been a guest conductor with CMM Choir over the years, but in 2010, she became the choir's full-time musical director. Annie's choice of song is Could It Possibly Happen to Me? From the Christmas musical, While Shepherds Watched. Annie chose this one not because it's her favourite Roger Jones song, but because she finds it often moves her to tears, as it was these words, When I consider the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, the heavens so grand, from Psalm 8, during a Billy Graham film in the 1960s that prompted Roger Jones to give his life to the Lord and become a Christian.
I dreamed, could it possibly happen to me?
Andrea Harden sings in the West Birmingham Choir. Andrea has chosen I Waited Patiently for the Lord from the Christmas musical Simeon.
The song, which is based on Psalm 40, has had special meaning for Andrea from the time she first heard it. Waiting is hard, she says, whether it is for your first child or grandchild, or pandemic restrictions to lift, for healing of someone you love, for Jesus to come again. God is with us in the waiting, in the arriving, in the rescue. It is always a new song with him, a new song for the rock on whom we stand.
Sylvia Worley felt that the time had come to step down from leading the West Birmingham choir, although she still enjoys singing in the choir. Sylvia was succeeded by Helen Pollard, who had been working full-time for Christian Music Ministries alongside Roger and Annie. Helen has chosen a song from the musical Pharisee that was originally just for a solo singer who stood watching the crucifixion and understood what was unfolding before her. Jesus was dying on the cross for love of each one of us, that we might have real life now and eternal life to come.
In Helen's own words, Annie Rackley has arranged this song beautifully for choir, but it had hardly ever been performed and never recorded until the pandemic, when we were all isolated and having to make music by recording on our mobile phones at home. I chose this special arrangement by Annie so that CMM Choir could sing it, and for its powerful gospel message. As you listen, allow the truth of the gospel to touch your heart once more. Jesus' great love for each one of us took him to the cross, that we might truly live with him.
Thank you.
soloists, and she has chosen the song Are You in the Book from the musical Angel Voices. Roger loves this hymn as it expresses great theology, but also means a lot to him personally. God's amazing grace despite all his failures. Guilty, vile and helpless we, spotless Lamb of God is he. Roger says he cannot but cry out, "Hallelujah, what a saviour!" He feels that in its simplicity and effectiveness, this setting is one with which he is most satisfied.
took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed.
Nearly come to the end of the programme, but we've got a setting Roger's made. It's an old hymn, How Good is the God We Adore. And I just wanted to highlight some words from verse 2, which sum up where CMM Choir is at the moment, which is, we'll praise him for all that is past and trust him for all that's to come.
Thank you. know, every time, this is the second time I've seen the evening and been to rehearsals, and I get really embarrassed when I hear my name too many times. because really, it must always be about Jesus. It must be about him. But of course, the amazing thing is that God uses ordinary people. He uses plonkers like me. I want to tell you, the plonk level sometimes is very high. But that's what the gospel's all about. It's all about the goodness of God. That God knew about how good he is, and that his amazing grace that he chooses to use us. And it's not just one people, it's not just leaders, it's everybody, because where would a composer be without this lot? All you'd have would be dots and dashes on a piece of paper. That's all you have. To bring it to life. And where would we be without people like Annie? Not that there's anybody else like Annie, but people like Annie. to be able to bring those people alive with all the history of famous conductors that we've had mentioned already tonight. And that's been amazing. But I think I better explain myself just a little bit. Why was that one particular song so important? Not Manos Horas, and that was obviously the one I'm most satisfied with musically. But there's another one. Before I move off Manos Horas, I just want to tell you that, you know, the first time I managed to get myself in the Christian press was about Manos Horas, and it was in a little booklet called Christian Crackers. And he said, and the composer, little Simon stories, and says, at one point in the rehearsals, the conductor in the performance of From Fairy Freedom turned and said, we're going to go back to guilty, vile, and helpless sopranos. But he didn't mean it like that. Why was that one song, though, when I consider the works of your fingers? Because I can remember way back, and I'm giving you this history now, because you can think, has it happened to you yet? Because in that nightmare, could it certainly happen? Did it certainly happen to me? Could it actually happen? Well, it did happen to me, because as a teenager, only weeks before I went off to music college, and I'd already decided to become a music teacher, but as a teenager, I was trying ever so hard to be a Christian. I was in a youth group, I got a girlfriend that I was trying to impress, Mary knows all about that, and I said, yes, I want to be a Christian, and I kept praying, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes. And I thought, I can't keep saying that. And there was that one night when actually it was a film, a Sunday night film, a Billy Graham film, and it was quoting words from Psalm 8. When I consider the works of your fingers, the moon and stars which you have ordained, what is mankind that you are mindful of him, and the Son of Man that you visit him? And at that moment, there was a picture of the solar system came on the screen. The one who made all that, and of course a lot more, was also interested in me, wanted to work it out with me as well. And then it was, I suddenly recognised and said, that's it, I can stop trying. I've invited Jesus into my life, I want to live for him. He heard it the first time, but now I know. And you know what, for all the music making activities, for all the things we ever do, for all the activities we make, and some very hard working people here and there who do all sorts of stuff all around the church, I want to tell you, it's only worth it if there's one thing that we know, that Jesus died for us, that we know that we belong to him, that we know that he loves us, and therefore we can cry out, hallelujah, what a saviour. And I want to tell you something. I don't know about you, but I think I've got an awful lot more to learn about him. But you've got to start somewhere. You've got to know that you said yes to Jesus. And if you've not said yes to Jesus, yeah, maybe you haven't yet realised, you maybe needed that moment when you thought, yes, he really did hear me. Yes, he really did die for me. Yes, he really does love me. And I want to tell you that this is the moment you could maybe say tonight, don't go away from me without knowing. Yes. He's done it. And now, hallelujah. What a saviour. So thank you, Annie. Thank you, the choir. And for some of you, 28 years of faithful service. But you know what? They're starting again on Monday and Tuesday, the 11th and 12th of September. You can join them. And they're going to be productions in November and December. They're even going to Christian Resources Exhibition. When it comes to Birmingham in September, in November, you know what? Why not? people about them and come and join us. The most important thing is not whether you join the choir or not, it's whether you know that there is a Redeemer, Jesus, God's own Son. That's what we say. Hallelujah. What I said, we're going to sing that now, aren't we? Have we got the accompaniment to sing it?